Hello, good morning students. Children, we studied that air is a mixture of gases. There are different type of gases, out of which the main gases are nitrogen, which we know it is 78%. Then we have oxygen, which is about 20.9 or 21%. And other than that, there is carbon dioxide, argon, and some amount of water vapor and traces of other gases. Okay. Now, this type of gases are all needed, as we know that most important gas is nitrogen and oxygen, which form 1/5 or 21% of the air. Okay. So, all living things, both plants and animals, they respire, we breathe in, we take oxygen, and plants also they take carbon dioxide. When we breathe in, we take in fresh air, and this is called inspired air or inhaled air. The air we breathe out is called exhaled or expired air. Okay, expired air or exhaled air. Blood in the lungs takes oxygen from the air we breathe in, as we discuss that we breathe in through our nose, and then it goes, the air goes from the windpipe to the lungs, and in the lungs the oxygen is taken by the blood, because as we discuss that blood requires oxygen because it has to burn the food. The process of chemical changes takes place because we take in food and food goes to the stomach, and then it mix with your blood, and then different enzyme they work on it, and then later on in the small intestine the food actually becomes totally liquid and the blood carries it throughout the body. So at that time blood requires oxygen that we breathe in to carry to different parts of the body. Here it is used to burn the food, which gives energy for all our activities, even for working and for playing. As a result of burning food, carbon dioxide is given out. We give out carbon dioxide because we are working, we are running, we are playing, we are doing different type of activities. The more we we do our activities, the more we give out, we burn our calories, and given out by the body is exhaled out. Okay. And exhaled air has a higher percentage of carbon dioxide that we discussed in the previous module, and then the inhaled air, and we discussed that it is warmer also. The exhaled air is warmer because we are working out, so it is doing lot of activities, so there is a working out, and then it given out, so it is warmer air. Now plants also, in addition to respiration, also carry out process of calling, we call it photosynthesis, where they prepare the food, they also give out during photosynthesis they give out carbon dioxide, and they take in the oxygen, which is give out oxygen and take in carbon dioxide actually, and release, and this air is needed for burning. Can prove this activity below. Now, which activity we can do here, children? We take three candles, which is given in your book. Three candles on a table and light them. Cover the second one, first candle. Take the help of your parents to do it. Cover the second one with and the third one with a glass jar. The glass jars on the third candle should be bigger than the one in the second. Now, what do you observe? That air is needed for, and when there is no, we have put the jar, so oxygen cannot enter inside, so the candle will not burn anymore, it will be put off. Okay, so this shows that it shows that air is needed for burning. Okay, so it is because burning candles need air to burn. When the air inside the glass candle is used up, the candle cannot burn any longer, and because of lack of oxygen it put off. Okay, children, air contains oxygen, which is needed for burning. So if you light a candle jar over it or just a glass over it, that you obstruct the oxygen from entering, so that candle will no more be lighted, it will be put out. Moving air can support parachute. As you have seen, parachutes, they open and they people, they take the help of parachute to come down. It is with the help of moving air. Even gliders, you have seen kites, without air you cannot fly kites. Air is used to inflate footballs. You must have seen use those pumping machines or even to for your bicycle tube to filling air. And so air is used to inflate footballs. Footballs, when you go to buy footballs in the shop, it is not inflated. They inflate, have you seen? They use the air, they put the air inside, and the tubes of the vehicles, you must have seen your bicycle or your cars or motorbikes where air is inflated through the tubes. Okay? It can push sailboats with the help of air, the sailboats move. You must have seen the sails. This is the purpose of the sails. Without this, you cannot move. Suppose this is your boat. This is your sail, children. So this is moved with the help of air. Turn the blades of a windmill where they produce electricity. Only air is there, that's why they place it on the, maybe on the mountain slopes or in the desert area where there is a lot of air without any obstruction. To draw water or generate electricity also. So these, that's why air is needed. Air is everywhere. Without air, we cannot do all these functions. So air is needed not only for burning, for other purposes also. Okay, thank you, children.